guys, today we are going to play Rohan against Hard Army in Battle for Middle-earth 1 on the patch 2.22 in the Dwarven mod, and I'm very curious about the changes they have implemented into this new mod, into the new Rohan, because Rohan is one of my most favorite factions. I hope they didn't change too much, but we will take a look into that together. All right, so from the heroes, we already see new faces. We have Erkenbrand, Gamling, and also Elfhelm. And also, they removed Aragorn, Gimli, and Legolas from the Rohan faction. Hopefully, the added three new heroes are going to be nearly as good as the heroes they removed. Even though I have my doubts, because nobody can be as good as Gimli, Legolas, and Aragorn combination. So, Forts of Isen, the classical map, and also new design for the peasants. They have now different weapons, as you can see and tell. They have spears, knives, swords, axes. So literally they took whatever they could find, which kind of makes sense, right? Because in the Battle of Helm's Deep, they didn't have great and quality weapons, you know? They needed to just pick up whatever they could find to fight with. So let's grab those settlements. And also, look at that. Merry has also an ability now. Esquire of Rohan increases armor and health, which is a passive ability. And he needs to be level 4 for that. Do we have any new structures? The answer is yes. We have a barracks now. Rohan barracks for 300. Train Rohan battering rams, Westfold militia, and door wardens. And also, I believe you can still recruit peasants. And look at that. Horsemen of the Mark. Defenders of the Vault. Upgrades expires in 60 seconds for 680. Holy guacamole, it's expensive. Hold on a second, we need to cancel the farm. This way we can get you know, the farm outside first. Let's cancel that. There we go. And what we can do is we can try to creep the Vorglian eventually. Now we need to build one more farm inside the genes. And first of all, just like in the Erebor faction review we did yesterday, we can also you know, recruit all the heroes first, especially the new heroes. I would like to see how strong they are. And this is going to be kind of challenging to creep, so we need to lure them one by one, ideally. Okay, now follow me. This one can follow now. That's how you want to do that. You can't fight them against two of them at the same time. You want to split them, you know. And also micro whip the hobbit, just like that. And after we kill him, we can just move on to the second one. This way we can creep easily with two peasants and one Pippin. Or, you know, in this case, Meriodoc Brandybog. Hobbit is a hobbit, you know what I'm saying? Alright. Easy peasy, guys. Let's now focus down the lair ASAP before more wargs are gonna respawn. We need more farms inside the genes. Inside the castle. I keep saying inside the genes. I don't know why. Sorry for that. Alright, so we have also no clue about the enemy faction just yet, but they will be attacking us very, very soon anyway. Come on, Hobbit, share experience. Yes, we got level 2 with the Hobbit now, even though he didn't get the last hit, but it's fine. Because in Battle for Middle-earth 1 games, or BFME games generally, there is something called, which is like passively leveling up. So by putting a hero next to another hero, you can also level up both the heroes at the same time. They will share experience. Stable costs us still the same money, and armory costs us the same money as well. Same also the statue and the well. Archer range the same. So, you know what? I would like to build the barracks. Oh, what is that? These are Urukai. What is the building? What is that? Dunland camp. Okay. Okay, he's feeling the creep though. Maybe we can help him out a little bit and take the creep ourselves. First of all, let's creep this. We need to micro with the Hobbit. We might feel this though. I mean, oh my goodness. Did we close the gate? Yeah, we closed the gate. We see war riders already. What is that? Dunlandings. Here we are able to recruit the Westfold militia. Defenders of the Vault upgrade is needed for that. I don't know what it is, by the way. I believe we will need a power point, right? Oh, fuck. 8 from Lothlorien. The 300s. Okay, you can summon them for a short duration. Okay, that makes kind of sense. I like that. And look at this army, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go for the most expensive one. Hold on a second. Eome is the most expensive one. 1900. I mean, that's a lot of cash. Hopefully, he's going to be worth it. And you can see the structures are a little bit tankier. That's a level 3 peasant. Normally in Battle for Middle-earth 1, he would be able to take down the resource building in literally no time, but not in this mod. And also the pressure is real. The Hard Army feels much, much harder, definitely, in the patch 2.22. The ram, And we are not even able to recruit any of these units, by the way, guys. Because we have, like, either no money or we need some sort of upgrades. Eoma, yes, Pietro, Outlaw, Leadership, and Goofine's Fury. Hold on a second. Mary, he's so young. Don't take him down, Warcriders. Oh, not even close, baby. We got invisible just like that. Okay, we need one more hero. Let's get his sister. Oh, he killed him. How? Boys, we have a problem. We have like literally zero farms outside in the minute number two, and we are surrounded. That's crazy. And we have the same structures, you know, as Rohan beside this one. And I would love to know the defenders of the vault upgrade. What is that? Is this this one? No, that's not this one. Master of Rohan. 8 from Lothlorien. Off from Sirion. Summon Antalias. Cloudbreak. Nah, we have also no PowerPoint for that. Eowyn, the shield maiden, is not even able to get mounted when she's level 1. Oh, what a horrible hero she is in this mod, dude. Okay, guys. Houston, we have a problem. We have even a hero now. Ugluk, he's already level 3. He was able to creep. Let me tell you that much. It's about time for them to make siege weapons and say, knock, knock, knock. Who is here? The Uruks. Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys. Oh, my goodness, man. We have also no money. That's the problemo. Let's go for the elf helm. But how bad is that, actually? The Eowyn isn't able to get mounted when she's level 1. It's horrible. And do we actually... I don't know what we are supposed to do. Like, we can, of course, recruit additional peasants. But let's be real. They have, like, so many Warcriders on the field. That would be just suicide mission. And maybe archer range. I have no clue. Maybe the stable. Maybe the armory. Maybe that's the armory stuff we need to buy first. And also, this guy is not coming mounted. Level... No, Off-Rider. He gets more movement speed and more armor for 30 seconds. With level 2... Vigilance, line of sight, and allows Elfhelm to detect invisible units, okay? And we have also Marshal of the Eastmark, more speed and armor passively. And last but not least is Blinding Charge. Stuns nearby enemies and blinds pikemen, decreasing their damage. Very interesting. Okay, I believe you will need some sort of cavalry, definitely. And also Theoden is a bit more expensive here. He costs 1500 instead of 1200. And you can see our money is not looking great at all. And when you have 400 command points as good factions like Gondor, Rohan or Erebor, I believe the evil factions like Isengard and Mordor will have 800 command points. He has also like this Wildman of Dunedain units, they are looking like that. Like quite black. Not very greatly designed, to be honest with you. But again, that's a mod once again from 2013, you know? Okay. So... What is that? Oh, that's the upgrade. I am so blind, dude. I'm so blind. So for 750, by the way, it's also very expensive. From the stable, you are able to recruit the Rohirrim archers, and also the Royal Guardsmen for 1275. And you need to get your stable to level 3 first. And they are like limited to 2 battalions only. I believe they are like working similar to the Knights of Dol Amroth from the Men of the West faction in Rise of the Witch King. Remember, in Rise of the Witch King, every faction beside Angmar has special units. They are only limited to a set amount of battalions. You can't recruit more of them. And let's get this. And also, let's recruit Tyrion King. And then we will need to recruit some Rohirrim and ride out. Ride out and meet them. For the Fang Glory? No. For Rohan. For our people. One of our buildings is approved. Okay, now we have the upgrade that's gonna make it to level 2 instantly. Door Wardens of Edoras. Strong versus pikemen and archers, and weak against cavalry and monsters. So he has many Warcriders on the field. That means they will not be the best choice. And they are also extremely expensive. 1100 for a single unit, that's a lot. And also you need to get the building to level 3 first. The ram is not a bad choice. I like the fact that Rohan has also a ram now, that you actually have like some siege weapons you can recruit other than ants. But first of all, we need to save up for the King of Rohan. Now, we have also the chance to get the Horsemen of the Mark. So, Defenders of the Vault upgrade is already done. They are strong against Swordmen and Archers and weak against Spearmen. I believe they are kind of similar to the Rohirrim, but again, we will take a look into them also later on. But first of all, let's recruit the King of Rohan. I mean, money is problemo, but again, it's fine. Because once Eomer, he is hitting level 2 with the Outlaw Leadership, we will get money every time we kill enemy units. And trust me on that one, we will kill a lot of units in this game. Hopefully. Berserkers now recruited as well. Holy guacamole, it's not becoming easier for us. Eventually, at some point, we will need to demolish one of the buildings inside the castle and replace it with a well for the sustain. Now we will need Rohirrim. I'm actually pretty tempted to demolish this structure just to get a bit more money and build another farm, but you know, it's a level 2 building now. I don't want to demolish that, to be honest. Okay, Theoden King has also leadership as far as I can see. Yeah, the same leadership like in Battle for Middle-earth 1 is a massive leadership. To the king. Summons a pair of powerful royal guardsmen. Okay. When low on health. So it's like a passive thing. Whenever he gets low, he will summon some guard units around him. Rally to me. Okay. And then we have the Glorious Charge with level 4. Pretty similar to the Battle for Middle-earth 1 and King's Fever. Alright, we will need to wait for the Rohirrim to arrive and then we are good to go. So we have 3 mounted heroes in Eowyn. Eowyn, the shieldman of Rohan, she's gonna join the peasants, I believe. Okay, you know what? I would also like to recruit one of these. They are coming so fast, but they are... Oh, never mind. They're gonna be... They're only for a minute, right? Regardless, I would still take a look into them. They are being recruited extremely fast, though. So if you have a lot of money, you can recruit them from every single farm. Then you can make something happen. Since they're gonna expire anyway, I wouldn't mind to lose them, to be honest. So let's right now. Close the gate. Oh my goodness. Okay, we have this now. I don't know if we can use this. Alright, we need to build a post-line gate here, ladies and gentlemen. Eomir is level 2. That's dope. Oh, we got crippled down already with Theoden. I'm telling you guys, the hard army here isn't a joke. And I believe we will lose the king. Right, we will definitely lose the king, not believe. 100%. We can't save him. And that's bad, because now we have to revive him. Okay, he's summoning now some stuff, but it's not... And Ugluk has slain the king. The king has been taken down, boys. Can you please go inside? I built a postern gate here. Can they not use the postern gate? Come on now, really? If we cannot use the postern gate, we are in trouble, ladies and gentlemen. We are in trouble. Well, this is crazy. Like, this is something else. If you guys like the challenge, definitely go ahead and play this mod. And again, the download link is going to be in the description down below. Please come here. Look at this. I cannot use the postern gate. Already we detected the first bug in the mod, you know? Oh, he has like units and everything everywhere. Look how many. Okay, we need, I have an idea. We gotta make them follow us. So I'm assuming we will have to sacrifice eventually the Rohirrim. Because we can't fight this right now. They are trying to surround us. Let's kill some of these units, I believe. Just to get some money with the heroes. And we will also... I mean, the problem is... We have a big problem. Like, how can we now go inside? The postern gate is a waste of money. We can demolish them in this case, right? How can we go now inside... from the postern gate? The answer is no, we can't. So we have to open the gate in order to be able to enter the castle. And the second we do that, all the enemy units are gonna march into the castle as well. And this... Oh, there is money on the ground. I will gladly take it. Thank you so much, Heart Army. I need your assistance. What is this, my friend? That's a lot of army. Okay. Okay, King Theoden is here. We need him level 4 ASAP. Let's demolish that, actually. We will need armory, guys. We will need some sort of stuff to make our, you know, our cavalry units, the Rohirrim, a bit tankier. They are trying to surround us. Let's trample them down. I mean, he's chasing us all the time. That's not a bad sign. We are also getting some money. Do we have heal from the spellbook of this faction? The answer is no. We have no heal. But we need to now build the armory first. And then get heavy armor, forge blades, all the good stuff. I mean, I believe this is like a, not a resource building, it's like a camp in which he's able to recruit additional units. So let's use Pietro. Okay. Doesn't even kill the Warcriders, by the way. And this dude costs 1900, ladies and gentlemen. What? He's chasing us. Look, the army of Warcriders. But luckily, Eomer, and luckily in Battle for Middle-earth game, you are not getting tired. You can keep riding all the time, keep disengaging all the time. Let's trample them a little bit. Get some money from the trample and also more experience. Level 4 is needed for the horse lord leadership to make the cavalry units nearby of Eomer a bit stronger and better. And that's a massive power spike. Remember, Battle for Middle-earth game, mod or no mod, is actually based on leadership. 1800 and the 600. So the money is the same. Our elf helm is taking so much damage. We can spare no time. Okay, I mean, Rohan must end. Let's fight him a little bit. I don't know if he can actually... No, no, no. Okay. He doesn't want to fight. We need Banner too. And then we can demolish the armory and finally get the chance to recruit some units. And we will need a lot of units to be able to fight the Isengard army at this stage. I mean, don't cripple. Oh, he's not crippling us. That's good. I believe this guy could get the chance to cripple, but I believe he will also lose this dude now. Don't lose him. Oh, ram now, right? Ram. Run. Elmer, you need to... You gotta kill this, my friend. Please, Elmer. Can Elmer kill this, boys? That's a big question. You go behind the base. Elmer, you just sacrifice your life and it has to happen. Okay, never mind. You just can peel now. That's good. That was needed, boys. That was needed. Now we need Rohirrim, ladies and gentlemen. Now we need to master the Rohirrim. That's a huge army in front of the castle. This hero, Alfheim, is recovering over time. And we are in a really bad spot. And it's kind of disgusting that the post-time gate doesn't work, you know? So we need to run all the time. He's trying to cut our way from this area. So what we need to do is go to the middle and look for another ram. And eventually, you know, take the ram out of the game before he reaches out of, you know, our gate. Because if he does that, we might lose now the Alfheim. No. Oh my goodness, how do you want to deal with this army, dude? What can men do against such a reckless seed? That's the heat. And... Alright. So we gotta just take a look. I don't mind about losing him, to be honest. He doesn't give even leadership to the... He gives actually leadership to the nearby allied units. You see? Ram found. Nice. Okay, Tyrion King. Can you get mounted, please? You are mounted already. The banner. Don't die, Alfheim. I need you. Bring it to the ground. Elmer, please kill him. Okay, Elmer, good job, Elmer. Please run, Elmer. I need heal from the spellbook. I don't know. Let's summon them or something. No. What is this? Allows Galadrim and the hero Haldir to be built. Okay. From the Rohan barracks. So it's a passive thing. We need active stuff. We need active stuff. All right. We need more Rohirrim, ladies and gentlemen. One battalion is not enough. We need to build a well here for a sustain. And hopefully we will make something happen very, very soon. So we have now the chance to purchase with heavy armor, forge plates, and banner. Oh my goodness. Money is looking horrible. And hopefully with the Rohirrim army, and we will at least need 3 battalions, if not 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, to be able to outdamage and outclass this Uruk army with the Vork Riders. Rohirrim! So, we were able to kill the rams before they could reach out to us. And we need to do the same thing over and over again until we are ready. Yet, we are not ready to fight. Okay, we are ready to ride out. We will need a little bit more Rohirrim. And again, just take a look into the rams all the time. That's going to buy us some time, you know? But he has now crossbowmen on the field and they are hurting. Riders of the Mark. So, let's go up. Is he level... He has also leadership. Now we have more speed, more armor from this dude. Armor and damage. Hold on. There is Lourdes too now. Oh my goodness. Armor and damage from Tyrion and also damage and combat experience from Elmer. So long story short, we should have great amount of leadership for the nearby units. Eowyn has no special ability. Let's not trample them anymore. This guy looks like Aragorn a little bit. You know, the leader. You see him in the front of the battalion of Dunlands or Dunlands. Looks like a little bit like... Okay. Now open the gate. Okay. So I'm actually pretty tempted to let them inside a little bit. Kill them and close the gate. I think that can be a nice idea. So let's do that. Let them enter a little bit. He's using... Okay, let's close the gate now. Just make sure that we are not leaving the gate though. Okay, I believe that's a good situation. Now we can kill them. And get more and more experience. Don't die with the heroes though. They are important to be kept alive. And, you know, the best thing what can happen to us is if our Theodine gets level 4. Fear no darkness. Yeah, my friend. Okay. Almost level 3, that's good. We are also getting more and more power points now. We can open the gate once again and do the same thing over and over again. So we need to get it to... never mind. We have the money for the horse shields, which is more armor for the Rohirrim. So remember, quality goes over quantity, at least in this game. Let them go inside. Let them do this over and... Wait, hold on, actually. Elvin can maybe fight with them at the same time. So she can get level 3, and then we can get also her mounted. Alright, so he was able to enter the castle with a couple of these units. That's good. Now, we are getting stronger and stronger and stronger. Fighting around the well is always nice, because this way we can recover as we are taking damage. And level 2, nice. Level 3 is needed. And for that reason, I know it sounds lame and you are like, what are you doing, Shanks? I know, but I believe that's the way we can... That's the only way we can win this. And holy moly, man. I've been playing many, many 1v7 videos on this channel, as you guys know. But this one feels so hard. Look at this Isengard army. Oh, the ballistas now, right? Oh my goodness. Yeah, come inside. So guys, we have to go out and fight. Alright, so we have to go out and fight. Let's give them... I mean, we will get some money for killing enemy stuff. But I hope it will be enough. We have 2 power points collected. Can we do something with that? We don't need that. What we need is Cloudbreak. So ride out and meet them. That is Lourdes using the thing. Just trample them down. Kill the ballista. Okay, go back. Go back in the base. We want to fight around the well. Eowyn is getting melted down by Sharko. Is this Sharko? That's even a normal war rider, right? We gotta close the gate. Alright, just fight here. Let them come inside, I don't mind. Théoden is almost level 4. That's gonna be a huge power spike. I would rather give them actually armor than bleeds, because we are not lacking of damage, we are lacking of survivability. Nearly level 4. Come on, King Théoden. Come on. Oh, there is Lourdes still. This is Lourdes, right? Oh, nice. Level 3. Nice. So now Eowyn is also able to get mounted. So we have now 4 mounted heroes. And we can even get more of them. These 2 should also be mounted. Remember, that's the Leader Mark faction. And every one of them is able to get mounted. So let's ride out and meet them. Yeah, and we are, since pretty much the first minute of the game, we are playing without any settlements outside. That's kind of the reason why we have no money. That's a huge army. And he has now pikemen too. Okay, that's dangerous. So hold on, I have an idea right now. Hold on. Oh, wait. Group here, guys. And also let's use this one. We are getting so much money now. We can even trample down the pikemen with the glorious charge. We have also almost all the upgrades. But again, don't take too much damage for no reason. Let's go inside the base. We have just fish power points at this point, you know? We have 6 power points collected. We have the chance to call the ants, but I would like to save for the Cloudbreak instead. Maybe go for the ants, actually, you know? When I think about it. Let's go for the ants and summon the ants right off the bat. Okay, here's an explosive mine in front of the gate. So just, I believe he has nothing that can actually kill our ants at this point, you know? Can we give them all the upgrades now? Yes, we can. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we will also need to demolish one of the structures. Let's get this hero recruited. Let's get an archer range for the fire arrows, because we will need to make the transition. Also, here's a ballista there. We will also have to make the transition into the fire arrows. Let's kill the explosive mine first. Can you please kill this? He has too many pikemen now to count our units. Rohan must end. So the army of the dead doesn't exist here. So long story short. Okay, the pikemen are on the hand. This hero is also on the field. He's able to get mounted. What is that? Gains an experience bonus when near Théoden, Eomer, or Erkenbrand. Okay. And does he have also leadership for the nearby units? A master of archers, leadership to human archers and Rohirrim archers by 40% increased attack. That's good. And the King Standard, place a banner in the target area, replenishes nearby battalions and provides leadership. But it doesn't tell you how much leadership you get. Holy moly, guys, our ants were able to clean up. Kill this, kick this ant, please. Kick him. Nice, ant. Good job, ant. That's the ant I like to have in my team. Okay, we will need 3 of these archers. And look at that, we are also able to recruit Haldir, the hero, from the archer range. Okay. All right. Eomer's Fury grants him 100% damage in a small radius and 50% increased damage. Eomer is not slowed by trampling. Power recharge time is also reduced by 75. Oh my goodness, that's crazy. Alright, now is the time for the Isengard, of course, to spam siege weapons on us 24-7. which is not fun to play against, but it's okay. This guy's like a horse archer, by the way, guys. He's able to shoot while he... We need to save now for the three hunters. We need a little bit more than 2.5 power points. Almost 3. We will need 3 archers in total to get the archer range to level 2. And we are winning this fight. You see, outclassing the enemy army big time. But still don't underestimate them. Let's close the gate. Oh, but pikemen are here, right? So let's bail. Okay, let's trample them. Eomer is such a cost-efficient hero. And look how much money you get from Eomer's presence, you know? Because of outlaw leadership. There is money on the ground. Let's pick it up. And let's bail. You're right. Riders of Rohan. He's using whole ability too. You're right. Okay. Now what? You guys come here, please. We need to open the gate and go inside. And inside we can fight. But kill this mine before, please. Please, 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 please. Okay, we killed the mine for 10 more gold. Just avoid the pikemen. Enter the castle and close the gate right off the bat. Alright. That's what we are supposed to do all the time. There is Ugluk. We can kill him, though. That's a hero of Isengard. He thinks he can fight against us. Alright, level 8. Nice. And we have also so much money now, but let's get this and also Hero Hylian right after that. Okay, he's getting the Yeoman Arches. I'm down. I don't mind that, to be honest with you guys. We can open the gate once again and do the same over and over again. We have almost the power points we need for the three hunters. What an intense game it is. I mean, more command points is also, of course, for the enemy units, right? And especially evil factions, I'm assuming they have like 800 command points available. Let's kill Lourdes. Oh, he's crippling. We gotta use Glorious Charge here to be able to fight the situation. Okay, we have now the three hunters. I don't know if this is gonna be permanent. I don't think so. I don't think you can summon three of them permanently. I think that would be kind of too busted. Hylder is also being recruited extremely fast. Is this Lourdes running for his life? No, it's not Lourdes running for his life. Alright, we killed him. Okay, let's peel back. Oh my goodness, the Glorious Charge. That's why we are so lucky to not get one-shotted here. Okay, Haldir, how long do you need?
An alliance once existed between elves and men.
Oh yeah, alliances once existed between elves and men. Can you write? Nope, you cannot write. Alright, so we need to be careful now. Let's close the gate because pikemen are in the base. Alright, we need to fight this. At the well, with so much leadership, we can even fight the... Oh my goodness, okay. Now we are talking. Let's get this. Do we have Glorious Charge? It's on cooldown. But we cannot avoid these ballistas and the ram. Making knock knock. Who is there? Battering ram. Alright, King Sliwa, just get him experience a little bit. Do they have all the leadership bonuses? I think yes, they have also high levels now, the Rohirrim, level 9 and stuff like this. But there are some pikemen, right? No, actually not many pikemen around, so we can actually ride out and meet them. Let's do this. Kill the ballistas first, that's the priority. Before the Glorious Charge, please. Okay, go back inside, go back inside, go back inside, avoid the pikemen. That's a huge army of pikes and ice uruks. Let's call the three hunters. I believe we will need them now. And let's also close the gate for now. Are they permanent? No, they are not permanent, of course. Let's use this. Let's use right click. Does he have Slayer? Dwarven Vengeance. Buckler of Edoras. What? What? Hunter? I don't know. Do we fight this first before anything else? Now we will need Rohirrim archers, ladies and gentlemen. Did we not recruit any of them yet? No, the answer is no. We have no money. That's a problem, huh? Okay, now we can assist the fellowship. The monster trio. Does Legolas have not, like, what is that? Elf eyes. Reveals hidden units in a target area. Kind of useless. Let's use Knife Fighter. Can you leap attack or something? I mean, they are strong, don't get me wrong. But of course, the 10 is by far not as important or as impactful as the Army of the Dead or the Balrog summon from normal BFME1. And the fact that they are only permanently... Does he have Atelas? Yeah, he has Atelas at least. He can heal him up, okay. Alright, they will at least be able to buy us some time. That's good. Because now we will need Rohirrim Archers. And this guy was a horse archer, right? Yeah, so he can actually be with the Rohirrim archers in this case, gambling. No! Like this, gambling, okay? Fire arrow 400, it's a bit cheaper. The gate is being repaired. Heal up a little bit more and then go. Rohirrim, give them fire arrows first, this way they have more DPS. And for the worst case scenario, we have also Cloudbreak. But we finally have to actually make sure that we have some settlements outside under our control. This hard army, guys, is getting just too much money at this point. Okay, let's go. Aragorn, Hunter. Oh, kill the, please. Where is Gimli at? Gimli, can you kill this? The ram? Yeah, you can die. I don't mind Aragorn because I want to see the knife throw. Okay, he's dead. That's fine. It's not the end of the world. But what we need to do is make sure that we are closing Haldir. Yeah, you can protect this. What am I doing? Okay, let's write them down. Now we are getting money for killing this enemy stuff all the time. Write them down all the time. Eowyn, Shield Maiden, to make her a bit more tanky. We are still missing a full hero, by the way. We have one of them is dead. But our Rohirrim archers, I don't know what they did. We need more of them. We need more of them. Take the horses this way. The spam of the units is real. So, oh my goodness, man. Mine is also there. Come on now. Let's call the Ents. There is Lurtz. We gotta kill him. Can we do something else with the PowerPoints? Gonda archers and soldiers. Summon. Okay, let's summon the Gonda archers. Where was Gonda when Forts of Isenfell? Right here. Please, archers, just kill the pikemen. That's your goal. Look at the summon animation also on this, the Gondor ground. Oh. Kill this, please. Let's trample them down. Do we have no heal, bro. That's the problem of what we got, you know? We have literally no heal ability available for the spellbook. So we lack of sustain. And also lots of money is a problem for us. Don't run into the pikemen, please. Take the horses this way, yeah. Eowyn is the leader, by the way. Level 10 Eoma, that's good. Level 10 Eowyn, that's also good. And Haldir can just kill this ballista, yeah. Right? He has no pikemen around this side, so we can do whatever we want. And Eoma is making bang for us, boys. He's making bang for us. Nice. We get so much value from it. That's crazy. Alright. Just keep fighting here. Kill this. This guy is just getting too much money. That's the problem, huh? Leave no man standing. It's easier said than done. Don't run into them. And please do some stuff. We are losing. I mean, I believe there is no reason of actually capturing any of these settlements outside. Because the second we do that, we lose them anyway. And we will definitely need lots of Rohirrim archers to be able to deal with the pike spam. In long terms, we will have a big problem. Huh? Let's get them fire. You guys need to just keep your distance, you know, Rohirrim archers. Oh, we need to close the gate. Yeah, we need to close the gate. Get out. Get out of my base. 250. Theoden King can actually level them up. Okay, level almost 3. Haldir is also level 3. What can he do? Pinpoint strike. Single powerful attack that reduces attack speed, target speed by 50%. Lasts for 30 seconds. Oh my goodness. Leave me alone for a single minute, man. Come on now. Dude, okay. He's back. That's good. Alright, we need... I don't know what we need. We need shenanigans. We need to deal some damage now to his castle. The power points in this mod are not nearly as impactful as they are in Battle for Middle Earth 1. So with power points, we won't achieve too much. The power point advantage doesn't really do much for us. That's what I'm trying to say. So you guys, please kill the pikemen only. That's all you need to do. And the other Rohirrim can kill whatever else is left after the pikemen are dead. Do I need to use Glorious Charge? Let's use it anyway. Just to make sure that we are not losing too much. We have no sustain in the eco. And we will need to also recruit Erkenbrand just to see what he's able to do. That's why we will need to save money at this point. Okay, we have really highly leveled heroes at this point. Okay, that's good. Oh, there is a hero, right? Yeah, there was a hero. He's dead now. That's good. We can trample them. We are also getting still a great amount of value, but even with this money what we are getting from Elma, it's still not enough to actually get the units on the field we need, get the heroes recruited we need. I'm still kind of disappointed that there is no heal ability. Come on now, finally. Okay, there are no pikemen, right? So there are no pikemen. I like the design of the crossbowmen, they are looking great. Oh my goodness, please don't. Oh, Haldir was able to get inside. Toggle weapon, please kill this. We need to go back now. We need to go back now, boys. Leave me alone. We need to summon the three hunters once again defensively. Let's open the gate. Haldir is dying. And I believe he won't be able to save him or will be. I don't know. I hope so. Haldir, die. I don't mind about you, Haldir. Just die. No, don't die. I will try my best to save you. Oh, never mind. It was just not enough, Haldir. Sorry for that. Just like in the films, you know, they let you die as well. Haldir is dead, boys. And we can revive him, though, from the citadel. Okay. So we don't need to rebuild the archer range and get it to level 2. That's good. Okay. More ballistas. Did I hear ballista shots? Now we have this hero. We will take a look into him too. But he can't get mounted. That's very interesting and strange at the same time. That you can't get mounted with the Rohan heroes. Horn of the Westfold. Grants 10% speed and minus attack speed to nearby in... what? Plus 40% attack. Okay, never mind. For 30 seconds. It's like an active thing. War chant style. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate that on the Twitch channel. Means a lot to me. The red shield of the mark. Oh, be careful. Be careful. Be careful. Don't fight against the pikemen, please. The pikes are painful. Alright, Rohirrim. Rohirrim need to kill. Let's summon the Gondor allies, I believe. Alright, so peel back inside. What is this spam, dudes? This guy has so much sustain in his eco, that's crazy. Now, maybe we can now recruit the guardsmen, the elite units. I don't know if this is going to be a great choice or not. Anyways, King's Fever can be used to level them up. Alright, the Gondo is doing work for us. What we have to do, guys, and I believe that's something we need to do literally now, just wait for them, is we need to destroy the enemy castle. And leave the outpost for the last, you know? That's the plan. So wait for the guardsmen, the elite units. They've also the chance to get leadership of greater... has a greater effect on these units, only applies to leadership from Rohan heroes. And also the ride through. Okay. We'll crush them beneath. Make them a bit tanky, I don't mind that. Alright, let's go. Let's go now. Okay, right now. Right now. Let's defend this first before riding. Let's close the gate. Is the gate damaged? Oh, yeah. The gate is damaged big time. We gotta repair it. There is one more. Okay. Hold much longer, man. We are, our damage is really bad against the rams with the Rohirrim archers. But it's okay. As long as he has no rams, we can ignore everything. Oh, there is another ram coming. Just why not? I don't want to use Cloudbreak yet. Alright, so Theoden. Okay, let's just go. Just go here. He has pikes in formation too, but it's fine. Let's use Glorious Charge and try. Oh, what are you doing? Yeah, you do nothing, my friend. Just, oh man. This guy, that he's not able to get mounted. Doesn't make any sense. Alright. Go inside the jeans at this point. Okay, let's go, 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 go. Kill the Siege Wars at least, at bare minimum. Can this guy kill somebody? Alright, just kill the Siege Wars at least. Alright, level 10. Just kill the Tita and get out. Okay, let's not overcommit here, by the way. I don't want to lose my army because my... Again, we have not enough sustain in the eco, guys. So, ooh, talking about losing the army. We lost, by the way, the hero. That's bad. We lost the hero, boys. That's really bad. So, We need to revive him, even though he was useless. He's still only level 3. Trample them down. We get to get some money. Holy moly, man. Like, to be honest, that doesn't make any sense. You need to invest, like, so much money into this hero, and then he's going to be dismounted on foot. I mean, I don't like it. If I'm gonna be honest with you. Anyways, let them go inside. It's fine. Don't lose the Rohirrim Archers. They are very important. He has used now the Freezing Rain to nullify our leadership bonuses, which is not the best thing in the world. Let's demolish that and make a second well. The statue is kind of useless, if, you know, in spots like that, because we don't lack of leadership. We lack not all, we don't lack of damage either. We actually lack of sustain. So we have like way less units on the field than the Hard Army has. And with that being said, we need to make sure that we keep our units also protected all the time. Okay, Rohirrim Archers are taking care of this, no problemo. Lourdes is diving in using Carnage, but he can't do much. And he will be still taken down. Okay. Okay, more pikes are coming. Just close the gate. Just close the gate. Go inside, go inside, go inside, go inside, go inside. Okay. Now, our goal is to finish what we have started. You know, that's the goal. And for that reason, just heal up a little bit more. And then open the gate. Make sure that the Rohirrim are behind, but the Rohan heroes are in front, like that. And maybe this guy can also get this way level 4. He is almost there. So if we kill a couple of units with the Rohirrim Archers when this guy is nearby, maybe we can make something happen. Go Rohirrim Archers, do your thing. Okay, level 4, that's good, nice. Rally of the Westmark, decrease the cost of peasants, horsemen of the mark, and Westfold Militia. And with level 8, Hammerhand Reborn. Increased damage and gives a chance of to perform a devastating melee attack. Can only be used when on foot. Okay, maybe this guy is meant to be on foot. I have no clue. Okay. Many, many pikemen are... What is this, man? What is this fiesta in front of the gate? Holy guacamole. Yeah, just kill... We need more Rohirrim Archers, ladies and gentlemen. We need more Rohirrim Archers. Can you please get mounted? Okay, you can. That's good. Okay, we have now every hero from Rohan beside Mary and beside Haldir. But we had Haldir and Mary. They just died. And we cannot afford to revive them at any point. And now we have to finish what we have started. We need to go inside the castle of Isengard and take it down. And I believe he has both the outposts under his control as well. So the melee ones are leading the fight. And the range ones, the Rohirrim Archers, are going to just target the pikemen. That's all they need to do. Because our normal Rohirrim, they can kill everything else by just trampling them on the, you know, all the time. Looks like we have still the Freezing Rain ability active from the opponent, you know. Lasts a really long time. Okay. Okay, now it's time to move. Just kill the existing pikemen. Let's kill this. Alright, please, 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 please kill the ram. Don't run into the pikemen, though. The siege spam is real. You know, he's saying always the same thing. What is he saying? Can't hold much longer? You are full HP, bro. Okay. Kill this guy. Nice. Okay, we can write them down at this point. And for the worst case scenario, we have also seen the end summon, you know? Go, 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 go! For death and glory! This will be a day to remember. We also call the three hunters here, just why not? Just go inside the jeans at this point, my friends. Cloudbreak is still on cooldown. Let's use this one too, just why not? Use everything. He has no siege weapons here. I'm worried that he might get siege weapons from this side. And hopefully, I mean, we won't have the money to buy this after we destroy it. And hopefully he doesn't have the money either, you know? Even though I doubt that, I think he has a lot of money and he can buy whatever he wants to. But let's just hope that this is not the case. Just take a look into our heroes, don't lose them. And Rohirrim Archers are also very important, but I believe we are outnumbering him big time. Write them down. And if he comes with the siege weapons, we can also call the Gondor allies to take down his seat. siege weapons. So you guys please move to this side. Okay, nice. This castle has been taken down. That's very good. Very, very good. And now we just need to take down the castles, or the outpost rather, at the bottom left side and at the top right side. That's all we gotta do. Maybe he doesn't even have the outpost at the top right side. Who knows? Even though I doubt that this is the case. Okay, we need also more units. Can I get one more of these? Nah, we have already two, and that's the limitation. You can't have more than two of them at the very same time. So the Riddermark army is looking great, especially with 400 command points. You can spam them all day, all night, you know? Aragorn, can you use Blade Master? Gimli, right click on Extro, right click on this one. I don't know what this is, actually. But try to take down this outpost first. Yeah, there is an outpost indeed. And we also need to summon the Gondor allies. So, and Gondor allies, you just take care. I mean, this Isengard, I have not seen Saruman one time, right? I believe he was getting Ugluk and Lurtz multiple times, but maybe I missed. Maybe we killed him so fast that I couldn't see, but I couldn't see Saruman. And what do you guys think about this mod? Please let me know in the comment section down below. I'm curious about your opinion. Kill this. Why take so much time? Kill the soldiers. Okay, we need to capture this for 600. Okay, the price is the same. It also looks the same way. So nothing changed about this one. While the Erebor one was a bit changed, you had also the chance to, you know, place three defensive structures around it. We will lose this gate. And four chain needs Lee. So we need to build well. Only wells. That's all we need. I trampled something without paying attention, but there comes the enemy army inside the genes. You keep your distance, Rohirrim Archer. And you guys go inside the genes also. We have double well for the sustain. So we should be fine. We should be just fine. He has also no pikemen, so I have no problem killing this. And hopefully he didn't capture this castle. If he didn't, all we need to do is destroy the camp at the bottom left side. But there is the attack incoming now. Okay. Let's heal up a little bit, just to make sure that we are full HP. We have also a great, respectable army, guys. We have a respectable army. We will lose this outpost, unfortunately. Okay, let's go. Let's not waste time, and let's not give him the chance to actually capture this castle. Let's repair the gate in the meantime. I just want to... I will just ignore this Uruks. Let's build a tower here for the defense. And money was a big problem for us all game long, boys. Money was a big problem. We had like zero map control, and I believe maintaining map control against such a spammy faction playstyle from the Hard Army is nearly not possible. Let's use Glorious Charge. Kill everything. One of you Rohirrim Archers, please take care of this pikeman. Oh, he's going inside now with the Vork Riders. Imagine him destroying our castle, but I don't think so. He's gonna kill the whales, but it's fine. Just kill the buildings, please. And let's really hope that he didn't recapture this. If he recaptured this, this defeating or destroying this outpost is not going to defeat him. Alright, last building, let's use Cloudbreak to stun them a little bit. Let's build one more tower. Are we the... Yes, we are victorious, guys. Easiest game of my life. Hell no. That was pretty hard, to be honest with you. And we had so much more money than him, even though it felt like that we were always broke. I had like the feeling I had no money all game long. But it was still fun. I was missing Aragorn, Legolas, and Gimli, but you still get the chance to summon them from your ultimate power point from the Spellbook of Rohan for a short duration, howsoever. And, you know, I don't like the fact that a couple of heroes, they need to get levels first before you can get mounted, because Rohan is a Riddermark faction, and I like to play like the mobile faction the way the Rohan is in Battle for Middle of One. But of course, it's something else, it's something different, and maybe you guys enjoyed this. Let me know, guys, what you think about this mod, about the Rohan faction in this mod, in the comment section down below. I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck, and as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.